welcome to Arvind Singh Academy, and we are going to discuss today area related to circle. Area related to circle. So we have to study this area related to circle. So first of all, we are going to learn some formula which will be very important, and thereafter we will solve some questions. You know all about the circle? Perhaps you must be knowing circle is something, or in definition wise, circle is, what is circle? Circle is locus of a point which moves in such a way that distance from a fixed point is always constant. But that is in geometry. Here in mensuration, area related to circle, whenever you have to calculate this area, then this is called what? Radius. Radius. And the whole thing which will come from one corner to another corner, one point to another point on circumference, or any point which will join the two, that is called diameter. So this is called diameter, which will be equal to twice of radius, because this is also radius and this is also a radius. So D is equal to, that is diameter is equal to, diameter is equal to 2R. D is equal to 2R, or R is equal to D by 2. R is equal to D by 2. That you know. And another term is there, that is called circumference. Do you know what is circumference? Ference. What is circumference? Circumference is the total outer length. Total outer length. Total outer length, that is this complete length, is called circumference. Circumference for circle. For all other figure, the total outer length is described as perimeter. For all other, it is described as perimeter. So circumference is the total outer length. This length would be described as circumference. Now area is what? Area is, area of anything is the space, the surface, surface contained in any figure in the circle, that is called area. So area is, area of circle is the surface. This is the surface which contained by the circle, and that is nothing else. So area of circle is pi r square, pi r square. Circumference of the circle, circumference of the circle is 2 pi r. Circumference is length, and length is, you know how this formula came, 2 pi r, and why this 2 pi r square also came? You can analyze just for keeping this memory for longer period of time. I am going to deal with and tell you that why the circumference is 2 pi r. We know angle is equal to, from geometry, angle is equal to, let me write here, angle is equal to arc by radius. Angle is equal to arc by radius. This is from geometry, anyone can derive this. This angle is measured in terms of radian. Radian, something which is called in 2 pi, 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 radian measure in pi. So complete this angle, circular angle, is called 2 pi. Total angle, this total angle, if suppose this is like this and this is theta, this arc length is L, like this, and this is R, then theta can be described as L by R. This is small angle theta. But this complete angle in radian measure is described as 2 pi. And complete length, if I write complete length of this, then that would be circumference. So in that case, 2 pi is equal to, total arc length is circumference, is called circumference, and what is the radius? R. And therefore circumference of circle is 2 pi r. Circumference of circle is nothing else but 2 pi r. Circumference of circle is 2 pi r, right? Circumference. Now what is area? Area, how to calculate area of the circle? Area of anything is length into breadth. You know, area of anything, the circle is described as 2 pi r. So half of the length will be pi r, and this breadth is r. So length into breadth is area of the circle, because this half will be symmetrical, it will cover a rectangle of this category, and this half area will combine this remaining area. That can be proved further. And so length of this is, this 2 pi r length is equal to length, and this is for breadth. So pi r, this pi r is considered as a length, and this r is considered as a breadth. So total area will be pi r into r, that is length into breadth, which is pi r square. So that can be proved easily. So is area of circle h, area h, this area of circle h, pi r square. So these two formula you must keep in mind: area of circle h, pi r square, circumference h, 2 pi r, diameter is equal to twice of radius. So these are few concepts, easy concepts that you need to remember. Now suppose instead of circle there is a ring like this. This is a ring, and we have to find the area of this ring. Then what to do? Nothing to do. Very simple. It is an outer circle have radius r, inner circle has radius small r, outer circle has radius capital R, and inner circle has radius small r. Out of the area of outer circle, if I could subtract the area of inner circle, we will find the area of this ring. So ring is another thing related to circle which we have to study. Area of ring is pi r square minus pi r square. If I can take pi common, r square minus r square, or we can write a square minus b square is a plus b into a minus b. So that will come up. You can memorize in any one of the form. Ring can be calculated like this. Area of ring can be calculated like this. So this is what circle and ring. Let me wrap this, and thereafter we will discuss some more concept. Till then, you must note down this, you know. Note down, please. If this is not a circle but have a semicircle, so what will happen? Semicircle, the name speaks itself about the character. Semicircle means, semi means half. Half of the circle like this. If this is a complete circle, then half of the circle looks like this. This is a semicircle, that is like this. Half of the circle. If this is a complete circle, then half of the circle is called semicircle. So in that semicircle, what I have to calculate is, this is a center, you know. That is the other half part. You can for this to understand this, I am drawing this. This is the other half of the circle. This is the first half of the circle. So first half of the circle, this is what? Radius. And this we have to calculate this circumference. So how can you calculate this circumference? If the complete circumference, try to understand, the complete circumference is 2 pi r. This is the total outer length is 2 pi r. So half of them, this length is just called pi r. And this is 2r, radius of 2r. So total outer length will be pi r plus 2r. So circumference of semicircle will be pi r plus 2r, or you can say pi plus pi r plus d, because d is 2r. So we can write either in this form or in this form. Pi r plus 2r is the circumference of the circle. In that circumference, it will include the total outer length, that is this one plus this one. So pi r plus 2r, that will be the circumference. But as far as concerned with the space occupied, The lower half contain the lower half space, the upper half contain the upper half space, so it is just half. So for area, there is nothing to do except we divide by 2. Area of semicircle is pi r square by 2. Area of semicircle is pi r square by 2. Semicircle is nothing else but pi r square by 2. We can write like this. Area of semicircle is pi r square by 2. Then quadrant. Quadrant is nothing else but 1/4 of the circle. If there is a quadrant, think like this. Try to understand. This is a circle and here this is a quadrant. This is a complete circle and now I have to write this quadrant. This is a quadrant. So quadrant is like this, 1/4 of the circle. So this is also radius, this is also radius. So what would be the circumference of the quadrant? Circumference of quadrant is quadrant means 1/4 of the circle. Circumference of quadrant is pi r by 2 plus 2r and area will be 1 by 4 pi r square or pi r square by 4. The complete circumference was 2 pi r. So half of that will be pi r and half of that pi r will be pi r by 2 plus 2r. That will be the circumference of the quadrant, of the circumference of the quadrant, right? Okay, so I hope you got this and some other things I will tell you after the break. Got it? So, okay. That's all.